A father and his two-year-old son are ID'd as two of the three people killed in a car explosion that rocked downtown Allentown Saturday night. The cause of the blast remains shrouded in mystery. The DA has called it a criminal incident. Tonight, a family member of the father and toddler who died is calling it a tragic accident. Good evening, I'm Rob Vaughn.
I'm Wendy Davis. We'll hear from that relative in just a few minutes. But we begin with the latest on the explosion investigation.
A lot of questions remain, even now, 48 hours after the explosion that left three people dead and temporarily forced many people from their homes. WFMZ's Joy Howe has the latest on what we do and don't know.
Let's start with what we do know. One of the two adult male victims, David Holman, is a 66-year-old who is listed at living on North Hall Street at this address here. If you take a look, his address seems to have some paraphernalia going on. There's some flags outside. There's a lot of different wires happening, some large antennas on top of the home. We don't know if anything has to do with what happened down the street from him. We want to show you this address because we want to show you a proximity here. So if we zoom out, and you can see that Holman lives here, right? This is North Hall Street. Just around the corner is the intersection of 7th and Turner Street. So that's where this explosion happened to take place. Now, coincidentally, just down the block from that is going to be the PPL Center. Very busy intersection. This is a busy intersection as well, the 7th and Turner. That's where Holman was killed. So were two others, 26-year-old Jacob Schmoyer and his two-year-old son, Jonathan. The ATF says these two men knew each other. He even called them friends. ATF officials also say that neither one of these men were just walking by and got caught in this. They were both at this scene down there purposefully when this explosion happened. The coroner says all three, the two men and the little boy, died from traumatic injuries due to this blast. So why were these two men meeting with a two-year-old in the picture? What happened there? That is the mystery. So what do we know? We know that there was this car involved. Let's go to the car now because that could become the key piece of evidence. We know that it blew up. We don't know how or what caused the car to blow, but ATF says the blast was extensive. They are gathering debris from rooftops and sides of buildings, so pretty impactful. We don't know for sure whose car it was. Remember, Holman lived pretty close by, could have easily walked there. There are reports that Schmoyer lived nearby too. We do not have that confirmed. The main car from the blast and two others nearby it were towed away to gather evidence. And ATF says at this point, they're saying it could have been an accident, but Jim Martin, the Lehigh County DA, did say Sunday, we know there's been a criminal incident, and said that he was confident that the responsible person was probably killed in this incident. ATF expects to wrap up the scene investigation Tuesday and promise to provide more of these answers. In the studio, Joy Howe, back to you.